Good evening. My name is Rahul. I work in an ad agency in Media City. I have to say, aap confrontation handle karne mein kafi seasoned ho gaye. And I would like to ask you questions on two topics with respect. The first is, I do agree with you that when you marry your direct brother, the likelihood of handicapped children is very, very high. But I also agree to the fact that man was created with one pair and then they propagated from there. But when you put the two together, it creates a little confusion. Because if you marry your sister, which obviously the first few did, we should all be some level of handicap, you know.
MashaAllah. Brother asked a very good question. He tried to link the question that was asked yesterday and the question asked today.
I wasn't there yesterday.
Anyway, the question asked yesterday was that if all humankind has been created from one pair of male and female, how did humanity come into existence? So then I said there that the rule that time was, today the rule is that marrying among close brothers and sisters is incest. But that time the rule was that you cannot marry brothers and sisters of the same delivery. Adam and Eve is the first pair of human beings, later on their children, but marrying brothers and sisters of same delivery was prohibited, but different delivery was permitted.
Different
deliveries.
Deliveries.
If brothers and sisters born in the same delivery, they were not permitted to marry. But different deliveries, they were permitted. And later on, the rule came that marrying brother and sister, whether same delivery or different delivery, is prohibited. The rules keep on changing, but the final concept, the basic, is same. Now coming to your question, that if humanity was evolved, then Adam and Eve, they would have been handicapped. So that's what I'm telling you, it is not 100% that if a brother and sister marry, they should be handicapped. It's not at all 100%. Chances are more, maybe 1%, maybe 2%. It's not 100% at all. For example, if you have extramarital sex, not that you will get AIDS. It's not a must you will get STD. Chances are there. Whatever, it's not a must. For example, if you jump from the first floor. If you jump from first floor, there's chances you'll die.
Chances.
Yes. What? Maybe 1%. Maybe 2%. If you jump from 100th floor, chances may be 99%. Correct?
I agree.
So just because if I tell you, if you jump from first floor, you may die, that doesn't mean you have to die. The chances may be 0.5%, 0.1%. First floor is not very high. So similarly, there are chances, doesn't mean that the person will have genetic problems. So this is what, when you pose a question, you should know the percentage. The percentage is very small. And furthermore, that proves that previously it wasn't the case. So what we realize, that this is not a must. It's not a must. But previously in the olden days, yes, brothers and sisters also got married. But that time nothing happened. It's not a very high chances. And doctors, is it possible? Any doctor will say it's possible. If brother, sister got married and did not have genetic problem, very much possible. No one can debate. Chances are there, but didn't happen. So that's how humanity was evolved. And the ruling about the consanguine marriage, I already told you earlier.
Sahi hai.